Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, hello and welcome. I am Chronicle Cosplay, and today I'm going to be doing this Wendy from Gravity Falls makeup tutorial. Ooh! So exciting with the freckles and everything. I love Wendy. I actually love Gravity Falls. And so I thought it'd be really cool to do a makeup tutorial for her. Her makeup is actually pretty simple, especially because she is such a young character in the show. She's only 15. So I try to keep things pretty minimal except for the winged eyeliner, which is just a personal preference of mine. But everything else is pretty simple and minimal because she is very young. Just a quick disclaimer, I just want to remind everyone that this is how I chose to interpret the character Wendy, and I'm showing you the way that I do the makeup. You don't have to follow all of the steps, you don't have to follow any of the steps, but I hope that you guys find something useful and helpful with this tutorial, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. So without further ado, we're gonna get started with Wendy from Gravity Falls. I'm starting with my base makeup on, which I have a tutorial on, so if you want to check that out, it will be in the description down below. Since base makeup is done, we are starting with the eyes. I am using this cool tone brown shade to just give a little definition to the creases of my eyelids. So I'm just applying that with a blending brush inside my crease and just a little bit on the outer corners of my actual eyelid. And this is just going to provide a little bit of definition to your eye shape while keeping everything pretty minimal and natural. From there, I'm going to go ahead and use this orangey tone. I think it's called cream soda, actually. And I'm going to actually apply this onto my lid. This just adds a nice little bit of color and warmth, but still keeping everything very muted and natural on the eyes. Because again, Wendy is a young character and really doesn't wear makeup, but we do want to bring a little bit of attention to our eyes. I'm also bringing a little underneath the eyes as well. From there, I am going to take this bone colored eyeshadow and I'm going to go ahead and apply that to the brow bone as well as the inner corner of my eyelids, just to add a little bit of highlight and dimension to the eyes. We're now going to move on to eyebrows. So I'm first using this jumbo eyeshadow stick from NYX. It's a cream eyeshadow and it's actually in the color white. And the reason why I'm doing this is by laying down the cream white shadow, it's actually going to give more pigmentation to the color shadows that I'm going to be applied to my eyebrows, because Wendy has orange hair and so we want to match our eyebrows to the color of her hair. So this provides a really nice base and a more pigmented application. Once I have applied the white cream shadow, I'm going in with this Sienna red eyeshadow and I'm using a flat shader brush to pack it into my eyebrow. You want to make sure that you don't smudge or sweep it across, because that's actually going to smudge the white cream shadow and the application isn't going to look as good and it won't be as pigmented. So you really want to press the eyeshadow into your eyebrow. I'm then going over top with a lighter orange shade. I feel like this helps lighten up my eyebrows and also make them look more natural, because there's multiple colors in it instead of just one singular color. Then just taking some highlighter, I'm just reapplying that into the inner corners of my eye and also on the brow bone, just to give a little bit extra dimension and some more highlight to my eyes. We're now moving on to eyeliner. I'm using the Kat Von D tattoo liner. I really like this liner because it's felt tip, so it's easy to work with, and it also is waterproof, so it actually lasts all day, which is awesome. I'm choosing to do a wing liner just because I feel like it helps your eyes stand out a little bit more in cosplay, but you don't have to do a wing liner, especially because someone like Wendy is a young character and isn't wearing makeup at all. So you could totally skip this step if you want, but I chose to do a wing liner. So I just applied that to both of my eyes, and then we are now ready to move on to lashes. So I'm just taking my duo lash glue and I'm applying it to the band of the lashes. I'm using the Ardell Faux Mink lashes in the style Natural. I really like these ones because they're not as intense. One trick when you're waiting for the glue to dry is to actually bend the lashes back and forth, because it really actually helps adhere to the shape of your eye. From there, I'm just gonna go ahead and apply the lashes. I usually apply the outside first and then I use tweezers to apply the inner corner. And then from there, I just kind of work the lashes into my actual lash line, and don't be afraid to actually press them in. It really helps them stick. And then I just go ahead and do the same thing to the other eye, starting with the outer corner and then pressing to the inner corner and just making sure everything sticks. And lashes are on.
So now it's time to move on to Wendy's freckles. I am using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Dipbrow, which is actually for your eyebrows, but because it's this creamy pomade, it works really well for creating freckles. I'm using a lip liner brush and just dipping lightly into the Dipbrow and making little dots on my face. That's basically all there is to it when you are making freckles. You want to try to make them varying sizes because not all freckles look alike. It's kind of like snowflakes. They're not all the same. So I went ahead and just made sure I was making some that were a little bit bigger, some that were really small, some that were a little bit more defined, some that were a little bit lighter, and just kind of making it look more natural. From there, I'm taking this dark brown eyeshadow and I'm going to darken up a couple of the freckles just to give them some more dimension and have a couple of them stand out. And then I also made like really tiny freckles in between some of the bigger freckles just to add some more. Then I went in with a lighter brown shade just to apply some really tiny freckles because, again, freckles can come in different sizes and different shades, and I just kind of wanted to make sure that they looked a little bit more natural. From there, I'm taking some translucent setting powder and my beauty blender, and I'm actually going to apply that over top of the freckles. I feel like this helps mute them a little bit so they look more like real freckles and less like you just drew them on, and then you just kind of blend that out. If you feel like for some reason you accidentally washed out a couple freckles from the translucent powder like I did, I just went back in with a little bit more shadow to clean them up, and then your freckles are finished. Basically, the last thing you want to do is just apply your mascara. If you are doing a shoot or walking around a convention, you definitely want to make sure that you are wearing waterproof mascara because you don't want to see your favorite voice actor start breaking out into tears and have your mascara run down your face. Once your mascara is done, your makeup is done, and all you got to do is put on the wig and...
ta-da! You are now Wendy from Gravity Falls. If she was wearing a paladin sweatshirt. I will insert a picture over here of my full Wendy cosplay. It's cold and I was lazy and didn't want to change into my button-up shirt. So that's my really terrible excuse for not putting it on. But this is a completed Wendy look. I did forget, I just realized in the video, to set my face. I use the Urban Decay All Nighter. You wanna make sure before you put your wig on that you go ahead and spray it and set your foundation and all of your makeup because it's gonna help it last really, really long. So don't forget that step. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you wanna see more character cosplay tutorials, then please comment below what characters you would like to see, and also be sure to give this video a thumbs up so I know that you guys enjoy watching these. And if you aren't subscribed already, please subscribe down below. I really appreciate it. It would really help me out. And also, please follow me on Instagram where you can see all of my cosplays come to life. And that's going to conclude this video. So I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.